सो हेलो गाइस, आई एम बैक विद अनदर क्विक टॉपिक. सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ 2D एरे इन टर्म्स ऑफ पॉइंटर. आई नो दिस माइट साउंड ओड, लाइक वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट अ 2D एरे लाइक दिस, एंड इन ऑर्डर टू यूज द सेम वी कैन यूज द सेम दिस रेक्टेंगुलर ब्रैकेट्स. सो व्हाई बदर यूजिंग पॉइंटर्स? आई विल लेट यू नो. फर्स्ट लेट अस लुक एट दिस सिंपल प्रोग्राम वेयर आई हैव क्रिएटेड टू डायमेंशनल एरे. सो As you can see, I have represented it row wise, so it is better to understand. If I show the graphical representation, you can see this can represent a two-dimensional array wherein this first is the row 0, second is row 1, then row 2, then row 3. Here we have column 1, then we have Sorry, we have column 0, then we have column 1, then we have column 2, then we have column 3. So this is a kind of graphical representation of two-dimensional array, but actually this is not how it is stored in the memory. So if you want to know how this is stored in the memory, you have to look at this. So this is a kind of actual storage representation how a two-dimensional array is stored in the memory. Even not only two-dimensional array, bit of three-dimensional array also, they all are stored like this only. So what's actually happening behind the scene? If you look at the code, so this element 10, 11, 12, and 13, these belong to row 0. Actually, in the memory, a memory is a linear, so they'll be stored like right next to each other. So we have 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and kind of this. Suppose the address starts from 00, and the 00 address is for element 10, then the address for element 11 will be 04. Why? Because this is an integer, and size of integer is 4 bytes. And furthermore, one thing that we need to know, let me just type it for you. We can type it as not 2D. 2D array is the combination of 1D arrays. I know this sounds a bit odd. No, not kind of odd, but this is the actual fact. If you look at this picture, you can see this is a complete 2D array that we are looking at, but this 2D array consists of this array. This is the row 1, this is the row 0. This is the row 1, this is the row 2, and this is the row 3. Now we can see that all these are in the linear address, one right next to each other. So 2D array is a combination of 1D array. So we can see this ARR0 is a 1D array. 1 is also 1D array. This is also 1D array. 1D array. That's the thing if you are looking at. So row 0 is a kind of single dimensional array. If you like if you want to create what will be a single dimensional array. So if you are writing int my arr equal to, suppose we are taking it as size of 4, and we are writing something like this. So this is a 1D array. The same thing is applied here. So row 0 is a kind of 1D array. Row 1 is a kind of 1D array. 1D array, and this is also a 1D array. So this is a representation in the memory. So here we can see that this ARR0, this is a 1D array that I am referring to. So if I am only using a single rectangular bracket, then I am referring to a single array. So this ARR0, it will start at address 00. ARR1 will start at address 16. Why? Because there are four integers, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And the size of each integer is 4 bytes. So 4 into 4 will be 16 bytes. So the single array will be 16 byte wide. This will be 16 byte wide. So that's why the first array starts at 00 and the second will start at 16. Because from 0 to 15, we have 16 elements. Similarly, ARR2 will start at address 32, and ARR3 will start at address 48. I think things are clear here. Now going forward, this is the basic representation. Now if we look at the next picture, so how do we get the, how do we access specific row at the row level? So we know that this is my row 0, this is my row 1, this is my row 2, and this is my row 3. So if I draw here something like this, this is a kind of linear array of one dimensions. So if I'm writing in my program something like this array and indexing it as 0, and I'm not using other rectangular bracket, then it will be directly pointing to this, my row 0. This will be pointing at row 1. This will be pointing at row 2. Similarly, row 3. One thing to note here, these will be pointing at the addresses, not the values. Why addresses? Now, if I show you the next program for you, let me just type some quick info. It will be good. It's better if you can not there is a array name is a type of constant pointer. I hope you have heard this in some book or have seen in some books. It is pretty much clear that array name is a kind of constant pointer. Now here we are dealing with two-dimensional array. A 2D array is kind of a double pointer. Just keep this thing in mind, we'll be discussing it shortly. So here we are having the same array in this program. Now here I'm using this assignment to the pointer. So this ARR0, if I'm using just like the this ARR rectangular brackets and indexing at 0 will return the address of starting address of row 0. If you can see, this will return the starting address of row 0. This will return for row 1. This will return for row 2, and this will return for row 3. So this is the same thing that I'm using here. Now let's go back to the term that I mentioned. 2D array is a kind of double pointer. Now if in case you have practiced the pointers, you will know that if we are dereferencing a double pointer, once then it will return a pointer to integer. By double pointer I mean this thing, not data type, double pointer to int. Now this is fine. So this is the thing that I'm mentioning here. Suppose we have a double pointer ptr, okay. Now if I'm dereferencing it once, just like this, suppose I have ptr2 equal to, and then dereferencing ptr, so this will return a pointer to an integer. One dereferencing will return a pointer to an integer. If I am dereferencing it twice, it will return a integer. So if I int num and I am doing something like this ptr, so suppose this ptr is holding an address of other variable, let's say we can do something like this, int a equal to 10, then we can have something like int star a ptr equal to address of a, and this ptr is having address of a ptr. Now this is the thing that I'm saying. Now if I'm dereferencing this once, this will give the address of a, and the below thing will give the value of a. This is the main thing that we have to note here. So dereferencing a double pointer once will give us a pointer to an integer. So this is a single d reference I have done. This is a single d reference. So it is this is giving the address to integer. Double d referencing will give us the value. So if we go back, so this is a kind of single d referencing because we have not mentioned the column. So this is a single d referencing. So this is returning a pointer to an integer. So that's why I am capturing the same in the pointer one. So this PTR1 is consisting the starting address of row 0. If you can see, PTR2 is consisting of row 1, then row 3, then for the row 4. Now, simply I'm printing the addresses captured. Now if I compile proc2.c, okay, I think I have to open the compiler. Just a second. I have to open the shell. Just a second. Okay. So we have our terminal. So program name is proc2.c, then gcc proc2.c. Okay, compilation is fine. A dot out. You can see that the address of row 0, starting address of row 0 is ending at 210. Row 1 is ending at 220. Now if we see the difference, like between, like how much far these two rows are, we can do PTR2 minus PTR1. This will be 16 bytes. Why 16 bytes? Let's have a look at the picture. We can see this is integer 1, integer 2, integer 3, integer 4. So we have 4 integers in a single row. So 4 integer into size of integer, 4 bytes, it is total 16 bytes. So row 0 and row 1 will be 16 bytes apart. But we are getting 4. Why is that? This is because the pointer that we are subtracting are of integer type, you can see. So this is showing us that 4 integer apart. So let us typecast it to character pointer. So this will show us at the byte level. So I have typecast it to the character pointer, compiled. Now we have the difference of 16 bytes. You can also calculate this. This 30530, this is in hexadecimal by the way. 530 and 540. Now 540 and 530 are having 16 bytes in between. Okay, now if we move forward, we have this is done. This is getting the starting address of each row. Now if we look at the next picture, here we can represent the specific row in terms of pointer. So previously we have looked at this. So for row 0, this is the row 0, this is the row 1, this is the row 2, this is the row 3. So using this we are getting the address of row 0, row 1, row 2 and row 3. If we want to represent the same thing in terms of pointer, now array name is a constant pointer. So we can use the name of an array. This is the name of array. And what is this 0? This is the thing. This 0 represents which row we want to access. Just like we have written this 0 in the indexing, at the indexer we have written 0. Similar to that, we have to add that specific number. If we want, like this will find out that which row we want to access. Once we have added that, we need to dereference it one time. I've told you that since this is a double pointer, a single dereferencing will return the starting address of each row. So we have firstly captured, we have firstly jumped to that specific row, then we have captured the address of it. Similarly, this is for row 0, this is for row 1, this is for row 2, this is for row 3. If you can look, it is pretty much similar. This is the name of array, row number and the single dereference. Similar to that. Now let us jump to the code. So this is the code. Previously we have done this. Now we'll not be doing this thing. Furthermore, the syntax is this. We have the name of the array, row number that we want to access, and the dereferencing. This will give an address. So this will be giving us the address, starting address for a given row. Using this syntax, we'll be writing the same code. Now I have commented this one. Now let's look at this. Just see the syntax and see the code that I've written here. We have the name of the array, the row number that I want to access, and a single dereferencing. So this is for row 0, this is for row 1, 2 and 3. Similar thing I'm doing here, I'm just printing the addresses and calculating the difference. Let's again typecast it to character pointer so that we can have the difference of 16 bytes. Let's compile. This is proc3.c. Now we can see this is also working fine. The first row starts at 20, the second row starts at 30. The difference is of 16 bytes. You can see this is totally this is like pretty much simple. We are just using the pointer representation for an array and capturing the value into an integer pointer, because a single dereference will give us an integer pointer. I've told you earlier. Now if you look at the program for, let us go. Okay, just a second. Now this is the important part. We can say, suppose we want to access the address of a given variable. Suppose you want to access the address of 11, this 11. So at which location it is, we can capture that by, if we can just see here, let me just, so this is present at row 0 and column, this is column 0, this is column 1, row 0, column 1. So with the help of array, how do I do that? So if we see at the code, suppose I need to capture the element of row 0, column 1, which is 11. We'll do the following. So with the help of array, using array representation. Array representation is pretty much easy. Suppose we take an integer int num. Using array, we just need to type the name of array, rectangular bracket, number of row, this is row 0, number of column, what is the column number, this is 1. So this will give us 11. So if I print this, so row 0 element 1, column 1 will give us %d. This is the name of variable, save proc4.c. We have gcc proc4.c, a dot out, we have 11. Similar to that, suppose if you want to capture this 32, for 32, so in order to capture 32, let's see what, at which location 32 is. So if you can see, row 2 and column 2. This is the column, row 2 and column 2. So let's go, copy this, have a new variable, let's write is at num2. We have row 2 and column is also 2. Let's print it. Row 2 and column 2, variable name is num2, save and let us compile. So we have the 32. If you can see, we have the 32, the desired output we have. And this is pretty much simple, but how do we do using the help of pointers? That is the main thing. So for that, we need to take care of a few things. Let us just try that. Let me just that will be better if I can just show you. Let me just close this one, discard the changes, and let me just open it again. Okay, so yeah, we have the nice new picture. Now if I copy this, okay, Okay, so previously we had this thing. We were trying to access these rows. Okay, so this is our just a second, let me just. Okay, so this is a row 0, this is a row 1, this is a row 2, and this is the row 3. This thing is pretty much clear. Now, using the help of array, we are easily able to. We are very. It is pretty much easy to access a specific element, right? But let us just write for simplicity. Here, what we have done in the array. I think this color is fine. What we have done in the array, we have taken a integer, then we have written the name of array. Suppose I'm capturing 11 here, so row 0 and column is 1, semicolon we have here. So this is the thing that we have done. Now, if we see closely, this was a single dereference. Sorry. If we see closely, this was a single dereference that we have done earlier. This was a single dereference. Now, this is double dereferencing. So double dereferencing always returns the value. I think I have written it before. In this, I guess. So double dereferencing will return value. So if we try double dereferencing, what will be the pointer annotation for that? What will be the pointer representation? So what was the single dereferencing? Single dereferencing was something like this. We had the. Let me just increase the size and change the color. Let's take green. And 10 is fine. So let us do a single dereference up to row level. So we have the array name, we have the row number. This is the row number, and this is single dereferencing. Now we need to access the column as well. For that, just need to apply a plus here, write the column number, take into a bracket. Now do a double dereferencing. So we can have int num equal to. So this is a double dereferencing. So if you can just see, I know this might be a bit complicated. This was a single dereference. I think let us take a smaller pencil size. This was a single dereferencing, right? Which was giving us the address. So this single dereferencing will give us the address of row 0. When all this is combined, this will give us the address of row 0 and column 1. So this inside term will be giving us the address of this element. 11th element. Suppose this is 100. Now this star at the beginning will dereference this address and will give the value stored at that address, and hence we'll have 11. So if we jump at the code using pointer, just take similar to that. We can just take int num equal to. Now let us just dereference. Let us capture 11 again. Let us capture 11 again. For 11, what is the syntax? For your convenience, let me just type the syntax as well. Syntax for value. Previously it was for address. Now syntax for value will be, we have ARR, name of the array, plus row number, dereference it one time. Then we need to add the column that we want to access, and then dereference it again. So this will give us the value stored at specific row at specific column, and all this is equivalent to all this is equivalent to arr row and column. This is the once you are like practice this thing a bit, this will be pretty much clear for you. So let us capture row 0. So we have, what is the name of the array? Arr. Let me just confirm. It's, yeah, it is arr. Which row? Row is 0. And let us dereference it first. We got the address of that row 0. Now let us move to the column. We moved to the column. Now this gave us the address of this particular element. Now we want to access the value of that which is stored at that address. So dereference it again. Apply semicolon. And let's have a simple print statement. Okay, printing 01. Let us use this fancy annotation. Okay, save proc4.c. And this is for or not? Oh yeah, this is for. Compiled fine, a dot out. You can see this is 11. So this is working fine. If you are able to write like this, it is kind of an added advantage for the compiler. Compiler wouldn't have to do this for you. Internally, compiler has to change this representation into this one because compiler is able to understand this one more. So try practicing this one. So for you, let us try and access this 42. So 42 is located at row 3 and column 2. So let us have another copy paste and let us name it as num2 row 3 column 2. So this is row 3 and this is column 2 and we are accessing row 3 and column 2, we are accessing 42. Let us print that num2. And it is at row 3 and column 2. Save it and compile fine, a dot out. So we have the 42. So this is how we can capture and access the specific element of an array in terms of pointer with the help of pointer representation. So I hope you liked the video. In case you want to have like more topics like this, please do comment. And for the bonus, we can use something like this. If you want to iterate and print the complete array, you can use this. This was the array representation. Yeah. This is the thing that you used earlier using the array representation. This is the array representation. So let us just compile it. Proc5.c. Compiled fine. A dot out. You can see this is the basic representation how we have printed earlier. How we used to use this 2D array representation in terms of array. If you want to do it in terms of pointer, so this is a representation of pointer that we have already done. If you can see, I have just provided the row variable and I just provided the column variable. And the row variable, this for loop for the row will run till the row max, which is the macro that I've defined on the top. And this column will run till the column max, which is also a macro that I have defined. Yeah, if you can see. So let me just save it, compile it. I think it compiled fine. Then a dot out. This is also running fine. You can see. So try using this. I know it is a bit odd kind of thing, but it's better to use this. So I'd like to thank you for watching this video. Please do subscribe to my channel for more videos. See you later, guys.